Hello everyone, my name is Saurabh and today we are going through with the third video of WooCommerce Akino Connector series. In this video I am going to show you how you can create a simple product in Akino and then export it to your WooCommerce store. So as you can see, this is my Akino dashboard. So let's move on to the product section and create a new product. So to create a new product, I will just select a product here to create a simple product here. I will now select the family in which I want to keep the product. So now I'm going to enter some information regarding the product. So here I have provided some image attributes, so I'm going to add few images on the product. The last two are some custom attributes which I have shown you while mapping in the second video. So this is a simple select kind of attribute color. We can select option here. This is wash gear. So now we have provided all the details of the product, so just save it. And after that, we are just going to assign a category to the product. So I have a category named shirts, I will save it here. So once you are done with the product creation, let's go to export and create an export profile. In the job required, you can search for WooCommerce and you will get the WooCommerce export job. So we have now created the export profile. So let's go on the content section. So here you will get few details regarding filtering of the product. So you can filter the product based upon channel, locales and currency in which you want the product to be exported. We have some other attributes in the filtration, like you can select a family here if you want, if you have a product which is in a particular family. So my product is in shirts family, so I'm going to select shirts as family. You can also filter the product based upon their status, whether they are enabled, disabled or can be anything. Next, you can select the product based upon their completeness, whether they are completed on a particular locale or not. So if you want to export all the products regardless of the completeness, you can select no condition on completeness. You can also filter the data based upon the time condition also, like the product has been updated over the last n number of days or since this date or last export. So these are some filter conditions which you can use in order to filterize the data and export to your store. Next, you can filter the category also. So I have provided my product in shirt category, so I will just select the category shirt and confirm it. You can also use the identifier, which is the SKU. If you remember the SKU of the product, you can provide the identifier here. So that in that case, only that product will be exported to your WooCommerce store. So we have done with the filtration process. If you go on setup credentials, and here you can provide the setup credential of a WooCommerce store where you want to export the product. But since you have already done that, so there's no need to enter the information here. But suppose in case you have provided some other information in the WooCommerce connector and the data which you want to export is onto a different WooCommerce store, so you can just provide the details of that WooCommerce store here and the product will be exported to that particular store. So let's now save the export profile and run the export job now. So as you can see that export job has been started and the categories and attributes have already been exported and the product export is going on. Okay, the export job has been completed here. So let's now move back onto WooCommerce store. So as you can see right now that we have got the product which we have created in Akinio and it is here on the WooCommerce backend. Let's go and click on edit section so we can see whether all the information is there which we have provided on the Akinio. So here as you can see we have got the title, we have got the description which we have provided, we have also got the category name shirts here which we have created. Here you will go, you can find the price details which we have provided, which is in dollar. Inventory, you will get the SKU and the stock quantity. And in attributes, yes, here you can see the custom attributes which we have provided while mapping the product. So we have got the color and wash care also. And here you have got the image and the other images also which we have provided in the product. So let's just quickly go onto the WooCommerce store front end and find out our product. So right now I am at the front end of WooCommerce store. So let's just sort it based upon the newness so that we can get the latest product which has been added on the store. So here as you can see that the product which is exported here is on the front end. So this is the title, the price, the quantity is here, SKU is here, the images which we have provided in the Akinio also there, we have got the description, and apart from that we have also got the custom field also like color and wash care. So this is all for this video which I have shown you how you can create a new product and export it to Akinio. If you have any issue regarding the export process or the WooCommerce connector, you can raise a ticket at webcool.ubitest.com. Thank you.